lockdown series coming at you from Ollie's ASMR world. Hello there. How are we doing, guys? It's Ollie's ASMR world here. Hoping you're all well. It's Monday. Self-isolation for 14 days if you had symptoms, and now they're discussing a 12-week lockdown. So I put my thinking cap on, and if I'm going to be stuck in a house for 12 weeks straight, then I may as well make the most of it on here. Sky News went over to best hospitals, I don't know if it's in Europe or in the world, I can't remember now. But this, there was just loads of people there, and the way they're treated, I mean, like, it's hard, I mean, like, the treatment they receive for coronavirus is ridiculous. They basically have, like, this big balloon over their head. That's how I to describe it. It's inflated, like, and it's, their head is inside, and it's to help them get oxygen. It's some scary ass shit, I swear now. I think the worst part is that, say, like, if I caught the virus today, I'd be taken from my home, and I would not be allowed to see my wife, any of my family, until I ever came out of hospital, or they went to my funeral. And that's scary as hell, that is, because, okay, we're all scared of getting unwell in general. Like, nobody wants to be unwell and be in hospital. But at least you're right, okay, well, I'll visit a couple of times a day, whatever, or each day from family and friends. You don't get any of that if you get this. You just go there and that's it. I heard one theory regarding why Italy has been so badly affected, like, rather than other countries, other than China, Italy's like the worst affected in the world. And the one theory is that you have a lot of generations living together. So you have, like, the kids, the parents, the grandparents, maybe even the great-grandparents, because Italy has the oldest population in the world, I believe. So, like, it's less young people live there and more older people. You know, like, the average age or whatever is like 80-odd rather than in their 20s, so to speak. I think all these generations of people living together. So maybe the kid has it, goes out with his mates, catches it, brings it back, passes on to the grandparents or the great-grandparents. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And yet China are back on their feet, doing what they want to do now. And it all started there. There's talk of, well, not talk actually, I remember, some shops are even, like, upping the price of their products. Around here, in where I'm from, there was a video on Facebook the other day. Now, this lad went into the shop the day before, bought a big pack of tart roll for £5.99. The next, he asked the bloke who owns the shop, "Are you getting some more in?" The bloke said, "I've got to go to the cash and carry," which is like where you get your stock from. Next day, the lad goes back to the shop, goes to buy the same tart rolls again, and all of a sudden they've gone from £5.99 to £10. And he filmed this bloke. He's like, "Are you ashamed? You should be ashamed. Are you proud of yourself? Are you proud that you're putting up your prices in a desperate time of need for loads of people?" It was quite brutal to see, but I think he was right to do, because people will take the piss at this. When people are in need, people see money. Cha-ching, cha-ching. Yeah, that's all goes off in their head. So, what have you lot got planned if you are in 12-week isolation or lockdown? I've got some plans. I'm going to do everything that I don't normally have time to do. So, I've already got made a start on the back garden, because me and the family realised, if we can't go out for 12 weeks, we are likely to be in the garden a lot. So I've already cut the grass, which I wouldn't normally do till like April, and cleared the path. Yeah, tidied that up a bit. Going to start sorting out the borders in the next day or two. I've got, what else am I going to be doing? Clearing out my shed. Fixing that up a little bit, it's like tidying up so I can actually find things. We've actually like stocked up a little bit. We're not panic buying like people are doing, but we're just making sure we've got enough food in trips out that I'm on, somebody's walking towards me, I run like you say, and I lick it off to the other side of the road as quick as I can. You don't see me for dust. So if you see somebody walking a dog and then all of a sudden they're running like Usain Bolt on speed, it's me, okay? I ain't taking no chances. But I was really careful yesterday. Like, my wife is proper stressed about all this. Really badly stressed. Because her mum lives with us and she's like 70. So, gotta be careful, obviously. So I was doing really well. I avoided everyone that was out and about yesterday morning. I did not give myself a chance to see anybody or to pass anybody. Then I come back and the missus says, oh, you need to go over the road and get some flowers for Mother's Day. I was like, you're joking. So I went over to Tesco to get these flowers out. And then right behind me in the queue, a bloke starts coughing right off my shoulder. Like, that's just ridiculous bad luck. Give a dirty look like, did you need to do that? Seriously. I've just been reading this bit on the internet, well, on YouTube, on the comments section of a video, that this can, you can have this for 2 weeks before you show any symptoms. It's absolutely bonkers. So we have now, me and my wife, we have converted our bedroom into a penthouse suite. Basically, I was looking around the bedroom the other day. I was like, look, you know, we could do something with this. Because a while ago, I needed some storage space. Sorry guys, I've got a lot of sleep in my eye. I needed some storage space, like my DVDs and stuff. You might have seen it on a couple of my videos. I've got this like huge cabinet. All my DVDs and books are in there. I was like, this is just silly. It's taking up way too much room. So I said to my daughter, would you like it? She said, yeah, great, I'd love it. So I gave her that. And I left a big old space in the bedroom. I said, let's go and get ourselves a little sofa. I said that to my wife. So we're going to go second hand. But it's great. We've got the TV up there now. A Blu-ray player set up, Virgin is up there, not a Virgin, obviously, the Virgin media box, and a big sofa, big enough for the two of us, so it's great, especially if you're in for 12 weeks, it's just a bit of a change from these four walls. We go up there and have a bit of quiet time, or a bit of time to ourselves, because down here, there's always like four dogs in this room with us at all times, and my daughter in and out, and the mother-in-law, so it's just nice to have your own space sometimes. Now, tomorrow, I will be going through, just putting pigeons in my chimney, cheeky kids, start charging them rent. So tomorrow, I'll be going through with you lot, maybe not tomorrow, maybe on video number 3, okay? My top 5 things to do during self-isolation. Now, I came up with this list for a video me and my wife did on our mukbang channel. But I'm going to reiterate it. I'm going to give it out to you guys so you can take some words of wisdom from it and some hints as to what you could be doing with your spare time other than playing Xbox or PlayStation. Please, people, everyone, I don't care how old you are, how young you are, stay safe, listen to what they're saying. Don't be acting like a brat and going out with all your mates. It's not worth it, trust me. Do you want to see your mum, your dad, your grandparents ill? I don't. So just listen to what they're saying.